Hello students, I am Dr. Aruna Mohan from Delhi University discussing with you reproductive system. We have understood the fact that this system is important for continuation of species, and that is how evolution has taken place, and we know that we are at the top of evolution. We have discussed male reproductive system, and now we are going to discuss in this session the female reproductive system. Every woman has a pair of ovaries, that means two ovaries, and they are placed inside the abdomen, or ovaries are abdominal. Ovaries are filled with ovarian follicles. Near ovary, we can see finger-like projections, which are fimbriated part, and after this will start the oviduct. The ova will come out from ovary and will be taken up by this fimbriated end of the oviduct. Then there are two oviducts which go down towards the uterus in the abdominal cavity and end on pear-shaped uterus. In human beings, we have one uterus, whereas in case of rats, we have two, or we can say bicarbonate uterine horns. But the human female has one uterus, and both the oviducts will end on this. The uterus, which is pear shaped or broad at the top and narrow towards the end, continues down and finally ends on cervix. The cervical canal will end on vagina, or will continue through vagina, and vagina will open to the exterior by vaginal aperture, which is very close to urinary aperture. So, in case of female, or in case of woman, in the lower abdominal part, we have three structures lying almost together. One is rectum, other is uterus, and third is urinary bladder. In this slide, you can see tears of ovary, and as I have already told you, ovary is filled with many follicles. We call them ovarian follicles. Now, these ovarian follicles, they will be at various stages of growth. Some are immature, some are developing, and one or two may be fully developed. We know in case of human female, when baby takes the birth, normally we produce one baby at a time. Sometimes there are twins or some other cases. So, as a rule, one follicle will mature at a time. We know that in human female, there is menstrual cycle that controls ovulation at the mid cycle time, and that is a time when Graafian follicle will ovulate. Let me start the story of development of follicle right from the very small follicle. You can see in the diagram. Now, under the influence of hormones, it will mature, it will grow, it is stimulated. The word stimulation here means growth. And finally, it will grow to a mature follicle, which is also termed as Graafian follicle. Now, what is the difference between the two? The immature follicle is a ball of cells, but in the Graafian follicle, one can see a cavity, which is called antrum. You can see on the right side of the diagram, a mature follicle, Graafian follicle, with a horseshoe shaped cavity, antrum, and presence of antrum cavity in a follicle is direct indication of the fact that follicle is mature and is ready to ovulate. The Graafian follicle is not a ball of cell. It has structural details, like there is ovum placed acentrically towards one side, surrounded by clear gelatinous layer, zona pellucida, And now this zona pellucida is surrounded by cellular layer called corona radiata. Towards the periphery, one can see three layers: theca externa, theca interna, and granulosa layer. Then this arrangement leaves the space in the center, which I have already told you, antrum. It is filled with antral fluid. One more thing which I would like to make clear here is that because ovum is acentrically placed, that means towards one side, so at one point it will be touching the three layers: theca externa, theca interna, and granulosa. And that point is called cumulus oophorus, and it provides a seat for this ova to sit. Another thing which I would like to bring to your notice, students, is that when ovulation takes place, ova does not come out alone. It comes along with zona pellucida and corona radiata, which in this case we can call ova complex. So, ovulation means ova complex is delivered out. This cavity, which is filled with fluid, the antrum, it also has role to play. In the diagram, you can see at the time of ovulation, graafian follicle will come close to the outer boundary of ovary, and at this point, the cavity, antrum, and the fluid, the antral fluid, it starts coming out bit by bit, drop by drop, and along with this drop comes out the ova complex, and that is ovulation. Now, ova has come out from ovary and it will take its route to fimbriated ends of oviduct, then if fertilized, uterus. I still want to explain ovary in some more detail. After ovulation has taken place, this graafian follicle is converted to another structure called corpus luteum. On the left side of diagram, you can see big round yellowish color structure, that is corpus luteum. Luteum means yellow, and that is why it is yellow in color, and that is why it is called luteum. That means graafian follicle minus ova is corpus luteum. But there are so many other differences also. Graafian follicle had a structural configuration. It had some well-defined structures, whereas corpus luteum is again a ball of cells. The only difference is that these cells are very big with very prominent nucleus and very clear boundary, which are the features for a secretory cell. And you know, a hormone progesterone comes out from corpus luteum. So, there are two female sex hormones. One is estrogen, one is progesterone. The estrogen, the source is graafian follicle, and progesterone, the source of corpus luteum. That will also mean that estrogen is available in your body before ovulation and progesterone is available after ovulation. And that will also mean one more thing. Then in menstrual cycle, the estrogen will make follicular phase and progesterone will make secretory phase. These all are hormonal interplays and are very important for normal menstrual cycle to occur. And it is important for a girl to have a normal, regular menstrual cycle to be called fertile. Unless one has normal cycle history, ovulation cannot take place, which we can understand from this description. Now, corpus luteum is a temporary endocrine gland. Why I call it temporary and why I call it endocrine? Endocrine gland because it is secreting a hormone, and temporary because it survives in the ovary only for 14 days in case of non-pregnant female and 90 days in case of pregnant female. Let me first talk about non-pregnant female. It will die in 14 days. Now, graafian follicle ovulated ova on 14th day of menstrual cycle, that is mid-cycle. Then corpus luteum survived for another 14 days, which makes 28 days. And once corpus luteum dies, there is no hormone to stabilize the condition, and hence bleeding will take place, and that is the menstrual bleeding. And that is the indication that cycle is taking place. This is detailed structure of graafian follicle. You can see ova acentrically placed. You can see very clear zona pellucida surrounded by corona radiata. You can see cumulus oophorus, that is bed for ova to sit. You can see all the three layers, theca externa, theca interna and granulosa, and antrum is so well defined and with antral fluid. So, this is a graafian follicle which is ready to ovulate. You can see ovulation here. It comes towards the periphery of the ovary and ova is thrown out. This is result of very delicate, very complex hormonal mechanism in the body. One hormone or the other hormone, it should be neither less nor more. There should be proper proportion, and if that proportion is disturbed, ovulation will not take place. And that is what the fertility pill does. Normally for family planning methods, sometime doctor gives to the woman the pills to be taken throughout the month. And that pill is made up of varying amounts of estrogen and progesterone. And when lady takes those pills, the only thing it is doing, disturbing the balance. If you want to disturb the hormonal balance in your body, so that fertilization does not take place, so only way is either decrease the amount of one of the hormones or increase the amount of one of the hormones. So we cannot decrease inside the body what is happening, we cannot decrease, but we can certainly increase, and that is what the pills are doing. They are increasing the hormone level of one or the other or both, hereby disturbing the balance, and that is why ovulation will not take place. And once ovulation takes place, the corpus luteum is formed. This slide shows mammary gland, which is important part of reproductive system in female. This is also called breast. It has glandular part. It has space where milk is secreted, milk is formed, not all the time, only towards the end of pregnancy and after the parturition or delivery. And through this, the milk which comes is used to feed the child, and it has many medicinal and healthy things this milk carries from mother to baby. Now you can see the glandular structure. Glandular means secretion, and of course, it is very nicely tuned in the body that all the time milk will not come out. Only when lady is pregnant, then one hormone called prolactin, which is normally inhibited in the hypothalamus, and it comes out through pituitary. The inhibitory center is in the hypothalamus, the secretory part is in the anterior pituitary. Only when pregnancy is there, that inhibition is removed, and hence prolactin is secreted, and this prolactin helps in the production of milk in the breast, and it comes out through nipple, and coming out of milk through nipple is controlled by another hormone called oxytocin and also by suckling stimulus. So, you can see how well it is tuned with the hormones and with the stimulus. So, it is available only when baby is about to be born and when baby is born. So, you can appreciate the female system, which is so complex, very complicated, still it works so efficiently because hormonal interplay works well in the human body, as human body is a wonderful machine. So, with this we come to the end of female reproductive system. The gamete in case of female is ova, which is haploid, having X number of chromosomes, that means 23 chromosomes, 22 plus 1, 22 autosomes, and one sex chromosome, which is always X in case of ova. Thank you very much.